Hi, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. In this video clip, I'm going to review the tennis elbow and share whole blood treatment and hydrodissection of deep radial nerve in tennis elbow. Most of the patients feel pain in lateral elbow on their daily activities. A pain on lateral elbow on resisted elbow extension is the most reliable physical sign of tennis elbow. Let's close look at the microanatomy of lateral epicondyle. The common extensor tendon and the collateral ligament attach to the outer surface of lateral epicondyle. These tendons and ligaments attach it to the bone through fibrocartilage transformation called enthesis. The ligament is deeply located but cannot be separated from the tendon. The authors of this article harvested the enthesis segment and showed a microscopic image. The blue stained area is a ligamentous structure. Blue stained ligament component occupies much more widely of the deep common tendon in the insertional area. There are diverse pathologies. Fissures extending the normal fibrocartilaginous tissue, calcification foci, and hypervascular proliferation are major histologic features. These abnormal processes are not developed only in the tendon and ligament. Same features can be observed in the bone. This video shows a macroscopic feature of the tennis elbow. According to my observation study, tendinosis and tear are the significant causes of a chronic intractable tennis elbow. This video is another example of a recalcitrant tennis elbow. Tear extend from collateral ligament and deep portion of a common extensor tendon. There are many options for relieving the painful tennis elbow. I think any repairing treatment therapy has a very similar technique in elbow. I'll introduce whole blood treatment and hydrodissection technique of deep radial nerve. A proper patient position would allow the operator to practice comfortably and efficiently. If the patient has the right elbow pain, ask to put the hand on the belly. If the patient has left elbow pain, let the patient flex the elbow at a right angle. This position allows the operator to use his left hand comfortably. After pre-scan, I place the probe over the pathologic tendon on a long axial plane and approach the needle from distal to lateral epicondyle. This illustration shows a schematic view of anterior elbow. Note the cross section of superficial group of spinate muscle, and the proximal portion consists of fibrous band. Purple color indicates deep spinate muscle. Deep radial nerve passes these muscle layers called the radial tunnel. Superficial head of the spinate muscle forms a fibrous arch, the called arcade of Fourier, which is the most common site of compression of deep radial nerve. Cadaverdisis image is left elbow, and note the radial nerve, superficial radial nerve, and deep radial nerve. The radial nerve supplying ECLB could be entrapped between the superlateral aspect of ECLB and superior edge of the spinate muscle. The definition of hydrodissection varies widely depending on the procedure or surgery it is being used for. It has been described in preoperative therapy for adhesiolysis by introducing cell line under pressure into the plane of dissection. Primary goal of hydrodissection is to avoid inadvertent direct injection and the injury to the nerve. The secondary goal is to separate a potential soft tissue adhesion or obstruction from the nerve causing an entrapment. Let's get to the clinical case. I'm going to undergo hydrodissection first. So I asked my patients lie on the bed, elbow extension, and put a hand on the neutral position. Axial oblique image shows interfacial layer between the brachioradialis and superficial group of spinator, radial tunnel, and bony cortex of radius. Focal swelled radial nerve is noted proximally. Observe splitting radial tunnel. Then I draw blood from the elbow under ultrasound guidance. Now I'm going to undergo whole blood injection into the torn tendon. I let my patients change his elbow. I turned elbow flexion position and put his hand on his belly. I need to scan before the skin puncture. I put the ultrasound probe along the tendon direction and put the needle at the musculotendinous junction and move toward the bony surface of lateral epicondyle. I use a peppering technique. This involves inserting the needle into the tendon, injecting some of the blood, withdrawing without emerging from the skin, slightly retracting and reinserting. Thank you for your watching.